the new European champion, defeated Val Venus yesterday on SmackDown. Well, no candy, hearts, or flowers are going to be exchanged between the Big Boss Man and Mark Henry. Boss Man's going to look to have Mark Henry do some hard time.
We talked about Valentine's Day being tomorrow. I know what you've got for Valentine's Day.
What's that?
A little bit of poontang pie from The Rock.
Yeah, laugh it up. Listen, it's not my first time at the barbecue.
That isn't what The Rock told me. And Mae Young looking on, Big Boss Man glaring at the nearly 80-year-old love of Mark Henry's life.
I can tell you that Mark Henry's feeling very possessive and very protective of Mae. I'm a little surprised that Mae's out here at ringside.
Wouldn't you?
Well, I mean, again, Mark would want to keep Mae Young in the back. But a spirit like Mae Young is not going to take no for an answer.
You know who else isn't taking no for an answer?
Who's that?
The Big Red Machine.
Wow.
Kane returning with Paul Bearer, his father, in tow on Raw Friday night. And then the destruction that Kane left as SmackDown went off the air yesterday was unbelievable. With the tombstone pile driver of his ex-girlfriend, Tori.
Well, breaking up is hard to do, but giving her the tombstone felt so good. Talk about retribution for a broken heart.
And what do Triple H and Stephanie have planned this coming Friday night on Raw for Kane and Paul Bearer?
Each step along the way, X-Pac has been there for Triple H. And I have a feeling that X-Pac is going to go to Triple H and say, listen,
help!
What Kane, right, I can't beat Kane by myself. I need help from the Coalition. And you're talking about a six-headed monster.
Kane is so blind with passion. I mean, Tori was his first love. Tori didn't care about Kane. She stabbed the poor guy in his heart. Now, perhaps Kane went a little too far by delivering the tombstone piledriver. Perhaps Tori did have it cut into her, but the bottom line now is this, Kevin. Kane has got his eyes set on not only DX, but in particular, X-Pac. And if I'm X-Pac, I'm heading for the hills.
Mae Young had better be careful because the Big Boss Man appears to be on the warpath here this afternoon on Heat. A very good point. Be interested to see what happens this coming week on Raw and on SmackDown.
Jack Doan telling the former corrections officer to put down that little tool he has, which he did in the corner of the ring.
Mae Young's going over there and picking up that tool.
Look at Mae doing.
Well, God bless this woman's spirit. I'll tell you.
Hey, oh, get it! Like Boss Man in a sexual chocolate. They make a pretty good team, Mae and Mark.
Mae taking a swing at Jack Doan.
And Mark Henry telling her to get out of the way.
Boy, the spirit of Mae Young is absolutely incredible.
Look out. Reversal of Mark Henry. Wiped out the steel stairs. You could hear the thud echo throughout this full-out arena.
If you look at what Mae Young and the Fabulous Moolah have done for senior citizens, it's incredible. Showing them that life doesn't end at 65, it's just beginning. Stay active, stay young, get a young boyfriend. Big Boss Man with a nightstick, do whatever you want to do, girl.
You sound like a spokesman for the AARP.
I think it's great.
You know, we were talking about No Way Out, Kevin, earlier on, Cactus Jack and Triple H, big Hell in a Cell match for the title, but the winner of that match will defend the WWF Championship at WrestleMania. However, the winner of the Rock Big Show match at No Way Out is going to be the challenger.
And the Rock is saying it's automatic pilot for him on track.
Wait a minute, cover on Mark Henry, kick out after two. And look at Mae Young in the apron.
There's no stopping her, and there's maybe no stopping the Rock in his path to WrestleMania, except for
the Big Show.
7'2", 500-pound, massive destruction called the Big Show,
who just personally hates the Rock.
And personally chokeslammed The Rock a couple of SmackDowns ago. Don't think The Rock has forgotten about that either.
Boss Man laying a SmackDown on Mark Henry. Fans are all over Boss Man as Mark Henry's whipped into the corner. And Boss Man walked right into those huge arms of Statue of Chocolate. What a belly-to-belly slam! Mentioned Mark Henry's been more focused since he's been with Mae. He's a one-woman man now.
You really think so?
I think so. I think he's cured. Oh, there it is. Big leg across the sternum.
That should do it.
Boss Man's done for. There's two and a kick out.
Boy, Boss Man, an endearing image of the World Wrestling Federation over the past 10 years. Being part of the legacy, the heritage, and the history of the WWF. And really, really showing a way to go here in the year 2000.
Mae Young may not be mistaken for a Dallas Cowboys cheerleader, but she's cheering her man on. And look at Mark Henry.
Oh!
the back of the neck of the Big Boss Man.
Keep in mind, Michael, Mae Young's first professional match in the ring was in 1939. She's competed in 8 decades.
And Mark Henry's competed in 1, and Boss Man gets his shoulder up.
Oh, wait a minute now. Mae's throwing that nightstick in for Mark, but Mark didn't see it.
Mark never saw it. Boss Man has got it. Oh!
Mark is concerned for Mae's well-being and didn't see the plan.
And Mark's out cold. Boss Man picks up the win. A little miscommunication there between the Lovebirds.
Well, Mae Young tending to Mark Henry.
Valentine's Day going to be celebrated with a bump on his head for Mark Henry.
Well, while Mae is tending to her man, the action continues here this afternoon on